Whoa, this guy literally did 254 HTB transactions in a single year. Welcome to Data Stories brought to you by UrbanZoom. My name is Mike Cho, and in this series, we're going to use data to tell you interesting stories about Singapore. So real estate agents, what do people think of them? Let's try asking Google. Real estate agents are, not exactly the best type of reputation, eh? But love them or hate them, there's no denying that some of them make a lot of money doing what they do every year. Like I said, this series, we use data to tell you interesting stories, right? So the question is, are there numbers or data sets out there that shine some light on this trade? Well, turns out there is. So CEA, which stands for Council of Estate Agencies, they are basically the regulatory body that governs all licensed agents in Singapore. So early this year, they've actually consolidated and published a data set of every single HDB transactions that have been handled by a licensed agent. Now, granted, this doesn't include private transactions like those for condo and landed properties, but I think this still offers a great glimpse into this trade. What does this data set look like? Let's take a look. You can see on the screen here a particular row of data from the data set. So you see here, this particular agent represented the seller in a HDB transaction in Tampines last month. That's all it says. It doesn't say the price of the transaction, it doesn't say the unit number, but it does tell us roughly when this happened, which HDB town is it, and which agent was involved in this deal. Now, some big picture stuff first. How many agents are there in total in Singapore? According to CEA again, there are apparently a little over 30,000 licensed agents in Singapore as of September 2019. Given there are 30,000 agents in Singapore, how many of them are actually active in the HDB market? Let's just look at agents who did at least one transaction in a given year. For both 2017 and 2018, there are only 8,000 agents who were involved in HDB transactions. Think about this, there are 30,000 of them in total. That means only a quarter of them were involved in HDB transactions. What if we raise the bar further to only include agents who did at least one deal every month? That means 12 transactions in a year instead of just one transaction. Well, once we do that, the number dropped drastically from 8,000 to just 500, meaning only 1.6% of all agents are active in the HDB market roughly once a month. Here's another way to look at it. The top 5% agents did an average of 13 deals in a year, whereas the next 5%, meaning the 5th to the 10th percent, did an average of just 4 deals in a year, and the 10 to 15% group did just over 2 deals in a single year. So clearly, most agents don't do all that much, but a small group of super agents do a lot. And who's the number one of them all? That's the guy. Okay, let me explain a little bit. Each circle here represents a single agent, and it shows you how many buyers, how many sellers that agent actually represents in a year. And this is the data for 2018. You can clearly see there's just this one guy which clearly stand out from the rest. I won't mention his name for privacy, but I can tell you he's from ERA agency. So this guy, he by himself handled more than 250 transactions in a single year. That's like one transaction every 30 hours. He basically did close to 1% of all transactions in the HDB market in that year. Just think about it. He alone did 1% of the whole market. And this is only for HDB transactions, right? So we haven't included those that he did for condo and landed properties as well. So he must have done more. Thing is, will this data be actually useful to you as end consumers? Beyond just you and me being a little bit capable, finding out which agent, you know, is a top agent and all that. So let me give you a use case. Say you're a homeowner and you're thinking about selling your home. Instead of perhaps asking your auntie and uncle, hey, who's a good agent and all that, why don't we use data to actually find out who are the actual top agents who are active in your neighborhood? Can we use this data for that? Well, the good news is we've actually built an exact tool for this. All you need to do is go to urbanzoom.com, look for the agent search function, and key in your condo project name, or the HDB blog, or just a postal code. And voila, we will present to you a list of top agents active in your neighborhood. And in fact, you can dive in and see the track record and the recent listing activities and all their glory. So there you have it, super agents, they're out there, but they are rare. In the next episode, we'll use data again to find out what are some of the factors that can turn an ordinary agent into a super agent. Again, my name is Mike Cho from Data Series. If you like looking at data and the stories that come along with those numbers, definitely consider subscribing to this channel because we're gonna keep pumping out stories just like this one. See you in the next one.